not here today to glorify him. That's the last thing he would have wanted. And we know enough to know that. But I want to fulfill his wishes for this day. But I want to share with you the thing, the purpose, the principle which enabled him to die. The Bible tells us that it is appointed unto men once to die. He had an appointment. So you. Why? Nobody here knows who the next one will be that will be laying in the coffin. Because he was prepared to live, he was prepared to die. Thank you. Somebody once said, a man isn't prepared to die, he's not prepared to live. And I believe with all of my heart, you can tell the character of a man who's dying. It's not how we act and react. We feel good and have our health and everything is fine in the family and in the business. It's not the things we say then. It's what we're like when we're on a deathbed that really tells what we are. It's not the length of life, it's the quality of life that counts. It's the purpose in life for which we live that matters. It was a purpose for which he lived that mattered. It doesn't matter if a person reaches the age of 90 or 100 if they haven't found purpose in life, what is life? If a person dies at the age of 18 but has known Jesus Christ as Savior and has found the true purpose and meaning in life, he's lived more. It isn't the length of life, it's the quality of life. Why are we here? What is your purpose in living? What is my purpose? What are we here for? Thank you. nothing we can do. With all the advancements of man, there's nothing we can do. And it seems that with all the advances in medical science and all the discoveries and all the great medicines and things that are found and discovered, yet it seems that man still doesn't have a greater life quality or a greater purpose in living. Or even for that matter of fact, is he really living that much better and that much longer? With all the energy put into that, we eke out a few more months of life. More days, more minutes, and there, nothing. Nothing could be done. My times are in thy hands, and his times were in God's hand. And at God's time, I took him home. And in my time, God would take me home. I want to so live that when my time comes, I can go the way he went. Because I saw him go. I was there day after day, and I saw what happened to a man as he's going down, down, down. It was the first time in my life that I had ever really been in the proximity of a dying person. And I was in the room. I've read many accounts of how people die. That was so utterly peaceful that he was gone before we knew it. Just like that, he fell asleep in Jesus. But the Word of God talks about death, and for the Christian, it calls it sleep. It calls it sleep. When you're tired and weary, there is nothing so good as sleep. When you're tired and weary, there is nothing so great as to fall asleep in Jesus. Sadness. I came here with a message of hope. and firmness and solidarity because it's based upon the eternal rock, the Lord Jesus Christ. How God became man to die for the sins of all sinners, for the sins of his family, for your sins and my sins, because God loved, wants to reconcile man to himself, and God has provided for our every need such great love. That's my message today, the meaning of life, the purpose of existence. Whether life is long or whether life is short does not matter. What matters is how does one live life and how does one die.
Thank you.
For I assure you, my brothers, it is utterly impossible for flesh and blood to possess the kingdom of God. The transitory could never possess the everlasting. Listen, and I will tell you a secret. We shall not all die, but suddenly, in the twinkling of an eye, every one of us shall be changed as the trumpet sounds. The trumpet will sound, and the dead shall be raised beyond the reach of corruption, and we who are still alive shall suddenly... Who gives us the victory over these things in our Lord Jesus Christ. And so...
When will I see you again?